Thursday night, around 6:30, Carolyn Kelly, who's our chair of trustees, was in the church building, and she started to hear a rumble happen, and she described it as a freight train running through the church building. Well, there were no tracks in the church building. And she came down and she saw this huge pile of dust, this cloud of dust going up the stairs. And the next thing she did was to call me and said, "Kirk, you know, the ceiling fell." I said, "Well, I'll be there as soon as I can." She called the moderator, and he too was tied up, said, "We'll be there as soon as we can." So about 7 o'clock, we got down here, and I expected to see a couple ceiling tile, and I saw this huge mess. And it's what happened is that the plaster ceiling that was up there, put in the about 1920, let go, and it pulled down not only the entire plaster ceiling, but all of the drop ceiling and the insulation, the heat ducts, and everything just crumbled to the ground. And below us are smashed tables and chairs. And the thing that we got to give thanks for is nobody was hurt. At 7 o'clock, just a few minutes after all this happened, we had a group who was coming through to get ready for their meeting, the Motions Anonymous, who meet here at Pilgrim Church. The next night, also Saturday morning, was another group, free community lunch, and then Saturday night is AA. Sunday morning, again, we have a social hour, and so we continue to celebrate that nobody was hurt, not a soul. We're left with pile of rubble, plaster, insulation, smashed tables. I wondered if some of them went through the floor even. So we'll find that out as we continue to pile through and shovel